Hello, this is Professor Shapiro, known on the internet as Harry Hawk, and I'm making a video today to show you how once you've made a post, that it's fairly easy to edit it. And I've gotten permission from Constance to use her post. One of the things that's very important as in an online class or any class where you're using a discussion board, that it's really easy for people, your classmates, to go through all the posts, your posts, their posts, everybody who posts. And one of the real important ways of doing that is to break up what you write into shorter blocks of information. Long blocks of information can be a lot harder for some people to read through and to go back and find information. And so I'm going to show you that. Now, a couple other little things about Blackboard. If you see over on the left side of the screen, we have this little arrow, and that can bring and hide the course menu. And I mention this because sometimes you end up with a very small window for editing, and that can make things look difficult. And so sometimes by arranging things a little bit better, it will make it easier. So I'm going to scroll down here. And one of the options is to edit. And you should have the ability to edit any of your posts. If you don't, it's because the instructor, in this case myself, has turned it off. If there's a post that you need to edit and it's not allowing you to, send me a message. It's probably an oversight on my part, as these options have to be set each time a forum or each time any kind of similar structure is set up in Blackboard. There isn't a default. So anyway, you should be able to edit, and you just click on edit. What you see now is that below the post, we have a full editor. Now, many of you may have not put your name into the post, and this is something also that I want to address. You can change that simply by editing it. And what I'm going to do here is put in the word edit. You put it, you're not required to put the word edit in once you've edited, but I'm just putting that in there so that when we go back into the forum, you will see that I've made a change. And it's just like any text, I believe. We should be able to bold it. We might even be able to change the color. Perhaps not. But there's that. Now, finally, on the right side, there's this one other little option. It's a four arrows pointing up, and it is the full screen option. So not only did I hide the course tools, but I've gone full screen. And now we have all of our tools, and we have our message, and we're free to edit. Now, when I made this particular assignment, I listed a bunch of numbered points. And so I'm simply going to edit this by doing the same thing. You can see it took me a little while to find that last message. And even when we have lots of different messages, you can also do many other things in here. You can change the font. You can change the point size, for example. You can make it bigger if you wanted to. Again, not required. There is an option Sorry again, I keep on hitting the wrong key. There is an option here to spell check. You can pick the different languages. And you can also, now on the spell check, it's questioning the last name, which of course is correct, but we can see, hopefully you can see the, again, I did it again. Hopefully you can see the red underline under McClintock. And that's really all that it takes to edit. As one final point, you can just like in a document when you're posting and you're inserting a link, you can insert links within your document. And that will, you can see one of my other videos on how to work with that. And as you, if you want to learn what each of these tools does just by pointing at them, they will tell you what they do. You can insert a link, you can remove a link, there you can insert lines, again, spell checking, video, all kinds of different options, even insert a symbol like a copyright mark or a table. All right, so I hope that that was interesting. Now we're going to do just a couple more quick things. Eventually I'll learn how to get that right. We're going to hit this full screen button again, which is going to bring it back to the regular size. I will hit submit. And you notice the thread name has been changed. So that when we go back here, the thread name has been changed. And for any of you who have put, for example, Icebreaker, when you were asked to put your name in, please take this time to go and put your name in. And again, in most cases, when you're creating a thread, at least in my course and many other professors, your name is required to be in the thread name. And I'll explain a little bit more about that in another video. This is Professor Shapiro, known on the internet as Harry Hawk, saying I hope everybody enjoyed this video. I can make videos every week. If there's something you need to know, please let me know and I'll make a video.